Hello everyone, you are watching ITV Gold and I'm your host Aditi Lamba. Welcome to a very interesting and a very exciting episode of Inside Scoop, the show where we bring you top personalities from Bollywood and beyond, from India and here, bringing you South Asian performing artists and more that truly inspire everyone on a global level. Today on the show, I have a personality to who the words maestro or a legend could not justify the amount and the magnitude of work he has done in the music industry and the amount of love he has given through his art. On the show today, we have with us Padma Vibhushan Amjad Ali Khanji, popularly and lovably known as Khan Sahab. He has honored us to talk to us a lot about his art, his life, and what has brought him to the US. So, without any ado, welcome Khan Sahab on the show.
Thank you so much.
You know, when I say that the words maestro and legends kind of don't justify the amount of work that you and your entire family lineage has done, I think I'm being more than honest about it. When someone researches about your work, Khan Sahab, and all of the history that you come from, six lineages of musicians in your family, you being the sixth generation, and that continues with your children. Yes. How was that experience being raised in that? You were very young.
Yes, I'm very fortunate that I was born in the family of musicians.
Yes.
And a small place called Gwalior, very close to Delhi, very close to Agra.
Right.
And my ancestral house where I was born, now it has been converted into a museum. It's called Sarod Ghar.
Wow.
So it houses all our ancestors' instruments, and many great musicians, they have donated their instruments in that museum.
Right.
So you are most welcome to visit whenever you are near Delhi or Agra. Gwalior is a historical place.
Right.
Because my forefathers, they were court musicians in the royal family.
Right.
The Sindhia Parivar.
Yes.
In Gwalior. And legendary Tansen, you know, who was the court musician of Emperor Akbar.
Yes.
He was born also in Gwalior. So his grave, Samadhi, is also there.
Right.
So it is very fortunate that if someone is born in the family of musicians, because we, everybody in the family, they are just learning music. And being the youngest child of my father.
Yes.
Everybody used to teach me, guide me. And between me and my father, there was a huge age gap.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, he could have been my grandfather, yeah. But fortunately, he was my father. So, and he was a great musician, and he received all kind of honors and awards.
Awards, yeah.
And he gave a different dimension to sarod. Because sarod is a Persian word. Like sitar is also a Persian word.
Right.
The actual pronunciation for sitar is sehtar, means three strings instrument. Seh maane teen.
Yes.
And sarood, actual pronunciation is sarood, which means mausiqi, nagma, tarannum. So melody is music, the meaning is music. And sarood, there was always sarood in every era and every history. My forefathers came from Afghanistan,
yes.
Kabul. And I had the honor of meeting the king of Afghanistan, Zahir Shah, Hazrat, Ala Hazrat Zahir Shah. And in the year 1966, I visited Afghanistan with Hemant Kumar, playback singer, and Yamini Krishnamurti, dancer, Pandit Kishan Maharaj, tabla player. So it was a delegation from India. And the king was very fond of music. So my forefathers, they used to play rabab.
Yes.
So they modified.
And invented.
They invented, they modified, and they gave the name also. So sarod, now sarod has become so popular that in every state of India.
Right.
There are at least 500 sarod players all over the world today. So people are enjoying the sound of sarod.
Yes. Khan Sahab, you just, you know, reflected upon sarod, and that's exactly what I was getting to. You come from a family that has invented the instrument, and
yes.
You by far are probably the strongest face of sarod and Indian classical music when we look at Indian musicians on a global
yes.
level. You often say that sarod describes the emotions of human.
Yes.
Human
yes.
emotions is like perfectly described
yes.
by that. Is that why you've loved sarod? Do you think that's why, in a way, sarod was invented in your family?
You see, there, in every era, there were great sarod players, and
right.
But from my childhood, I wanted to say something different through the sarod. Generally, people play the sarod, they perform sarod, but I wanted to sing through the sarod. So that was the difference. I wanted to sing
right.
through my instrument, like human voice. So like the human expression. So this continuity was missing in sarod earlier, whoever played. So this is the way I express. So while playing the sarod, I'm not playing the sarod, I'm singing through the instrument.
Wow, you have invented or sort of created your own ragas.
Yes.
You're known for it. Is that how those ragas have been created? You said in a written interview once that I can look at an emotion or I can look at a situation and I have a raga playing. Mm. Is that actually true?
You see, raga, in other meaning of raga, is melody. Any melody which has a discipline of ascending and descending is called raga.
Right.
So historically, in our country, with the help of mathematics, ragas were created. Like seven notes, Saregama Padhani. How many permutation combination you can do.
Right.
But as a child, my father told me, it's only 5,040. So I never believed it. I said, my father, he didn't go to school or college. How could he be so accurate about 5,040? But today, it's a computer age.
Yes.
And through computer, if you analyze the seven notes,
yeah.
it is exactly 5,040.
Wow.
You know, Saregama Padhani within seven notes. But combination, like recently, I played Bapu Kos. I made
yes.
a raga as a tribute to Mahatma Gandhi.
Ji.
But that was on his 125th birth anniversary. UNESCO in Paris, they invited us. The former, our Prime Minister was Mr. Narasimha Rao. So he took me, he invited. So I created a new raga for Mahatma Gandhi.
Wow.
So he was affectionately called Bapu.
Bapu, yes.
So I called it Bapu Kos and we performed there. And I received a medal from the Director General, Gandhi Medal from UNESCO.
Wow.
So there is something, some relationship, some connections are there between me and Mahatma Gandhi, because most of his birth anniversary, his death, Barsi.
Yes.
I'm invited to perform, so I'm the first sarod player who played Vaishnav Janato and Ramdhan on the sarod.
Wow.
So the song, it was a difficult thing. It was a taboo to play even a film song of the sarod earlier. The sarod players dealt with grammar, with literature, with alap and jod and jhala.
Yes.
But how to play a song
yeah.
on the sarod, how to execute, how to render the melody, whether it's a film song or I play folk song also. Many songs composed by Rabindranath Tagore, the great poet.
Yes.
Ekla Chalore, and so I made an album also of 10 Bengali songs, Rabindra Sangeet. So Sarod has become more expressive, I can only say that.
So today. Would you say you truly sort of exemplify passion and profession? Is that kind of has been sort of the theme of your life in a way, right?
You see, fortunately or unfortunately, people feel that it is my profession.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is my profession because I live on music, I live for music. But basically, it is my passion. And when I'm on the stage, when I'm performing, there is a conductor somewhere, some cosmic power is guiding me. And I'm just transmitting, I'm just conveying the message. Because when I come on the stage,
right.
I don't have any agenda, you know, I haven't thought what I'm going to do. Everything is decided on the stage, and what I perform, I cannot repeat it again. That is the good or bad point about Indian classical music, that we can't reproduce the concert.
Khansab, you know, when you look at a life journey in music like yours, you were 6 years old, I believe, when you had your first concert.
I myself didn't believe that.
and that concert really brought you to surface, and there was no looking back. You have gotten so many awards, so many honors, respected in so many ways. Do you sort of still have the same attachment to music or the same dedication to it? Do you think, has that always stayed connected for you?
You see, each concert is a big challenge because we face a new audience every time.
Right.
And we don't know what is their taste, what they like, what they don't like. But I have that trust that whoever come, they love me, they trust me. And I try to give my best. I mean, whatever I think is right, I do that. Like in our country, we blindly follow convention.
Yes.
In religion also, in every religion. In classical music also blindly we follow the same convention, way of presenting.
Right.
I have been... I don't respect convention. I dislike convention because tradition allow innovation.
Right.
But we have to work for that. We have to discover. So, I'm giving more importance to compositions in instrumental music. You know, alap, jod, jhala, that has become a convention. Everybody, whether young, bacha, bura, jawan, koi bhi ho, they all play like that. So, compositions, according to my guru, there are many ways how to present Indian classical music. There is a style of tarana. Tarana is also a style of singing.
Right.
In 13th century, there was a Sufi saint, Hazrat Amir Khusro, who created Qawwali, Qaul, Qalbana, also created many ragas, many instruments, and a style of singing. Tananom Tadaredani. So he created a language of syllables, language of music.
Yes.
So I have composed many taranas, but this particular is very popular, Rag Bahar. Tadaredani, Tadani Dim, Tanatanom, Tadaredani, Tadani Dim, Tanatanom, Tanom, Tananom, Taderena. Taderena, 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 taderedani, tadani dim, tanatanum, tananananananana dim, tanananananana, tanananananana dim, tananana, tananum, tananum, taderena, tananum, taderedani, dakitak dumkitak ditakitak dikanda, kanda, kanda, taderedani, tadani dim, tanatanum. So this
wow.
is, you see, most of the songs, they are dealing with the language, lyrics, text, stories. But this is a style of singing, tarana, where there's no language. It's a language of music, language of syllables.
Wow, I'm so thankful for you to actually compose these and actually share these with us. I think our viewers are really going to enjoy this. You know, when we talk about the magnitude of classical music, and we talk about the intensity of preparation that it takes for someone to get to a certain level, how important do you think is that sustainment? Do you think you're always growing with music, even at a level where you are a Padma Vibhushan? Does the growth continue in that?
I think every day is like a new life. I want to learn some more, I want to do something more. Like one day I received an invitation from Scottish Chamber Orchestra,
wow.
Scotland. They wanted me to compose for their orchestra, which I didn't do it earlier because nobody asked me. So I composed about 45-minute piece, and I went to Edinburgh, and then I performed with them, and we recorded in a church. There is a CD also. published by World Village Record. And that piece, I given a Hindi name, Samagam.
Samagam.
Samagam. Samagam means confluence
of
culture. And the same Samagam we performed for the United Nations on 24th of October.
Yes.
There is a refugee orchestra in New York. So refugee orchestra, brilliant musicians, and our conductor was Lydia. She did a great job. So first, Amanayan, we played a sarod, Vaishnav Janto, Ram Dhun, and Rabindranath Tagore's song, Ekla Chalo Re. And then this orchestra, we presented Samagam. So now, now orchestras of different part of the world, like Chicago Philharmonic Orchestra, they played.
Of course.
So new orchestras, Dayton Orchestra in Washington. So this is my musical flirtation that I am enjoying to compose and collaborate with the different kind of orchestras of the world.
Do you feel the need to do it all the time still? Do you feel the desire to keep on creating as a creator?
Yes, the world should understand that music is music. Music does not belong to any religion. Like water, air, fire, fragrance, colors, they don't belong to any religion. And there are only 7 notes, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. And altogether, we have 12 notes. So entire universe music, whether folk music, classical, European, or Indian, everything is based on this, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. And collaboration, people also address as fusion. But fusion, you know, sometimes creates confusion also. But collaboration between classical European music, classical Indian music, it gives a very good message to the world that we understand each other and we respect each other. Like we, in my family, we respect all religion. I mean, I am born a Muslim. My wife is Hindu.
It's a Hindu, yes.
And she remains Hindu.
Yes.
My younger son, Ayan, married Neema Sharma. So my daughter-in-law is Hindu.
Hindu.
My elder son is still waiting to marry. Aman not yet married. So, but they are all both committed to music. We feel connected with every religion. We feel connected with every soul of the world. Because my father, who was my guru, he, in the very beginning of my life, he told me, beta, all of us have a common God.
Yes.
And we are the common race. Because every human being come and go in the same way from the world. If the arrival and departure was different, then there was a room for second God.
Right.
So there is a common power, common strength, common God, whatever you want to call. And we respect all faith. But I'm very intrigued, I'm very disappointed, and you know, when I see that in this 21st century, people are still killing each other on account of religion.
Yes.
This is very sad because what about the future generation?
Right.
What are they going to learn? What they are going to see? And I often felt that 21st century will be very peaceful, very successful.
Yes.
Because everybody is talking that my children are educated, my daughter is this, my son is this.
That is so true.
MIT and all kind of universities. But with all due respect to education, education could not create compassion and kindness in a human being.
That's so true.
So educated people still building temples, educated people still building mosques.
That's so true.
And church. With all due respect to all the religious buildings, we need more hospitals.
So true.
A hospital can serve all religion.
That's so true.
And why don't you make your own home, your temple, your mosque? Why do you need a building to pray and go out and all that? So these are very interesting subjects to think.
Yes.
That we go to worship in some religious building and you go there and ask for your protection, for your future, for this and that. But at night, somebody locked that building.
Yes.
Because that person does not trust that whoever is there will take care of himself.
That's so true.
So this is very, you know, there's something to think.
Of course.
What is the need of locking a religious building?
That is so true. That is beautifully said, you know.
Leave it open.
Yes.
If that is a god, if that is a deity, if there is a darga or temple or church or gurdwara,
right.
Nobody should lock it.
That's so true.
Because if there is somebody in that building, they will take care of himself.
That is so true.
So it's very contradictory, so many things. But we must bow down to, when I do, main jab, you know, sijda bolte hain, Urdu mein. So jab main sijda karta hoon zameen pe, so I am bowing down to that power who bring us to the world and take us away from the world. So that is very important for all of us to think, and we need more hospitals in the world.
Yes, for sure.
We are still trying to destroy a mosque or trying to destroy a temple or building a mosque or building a temple. It's fine. But please think that a hospital will serve all the religion of the world. And a poor man cannot afford a good hospital.
That's so true. That is so true. I hope that if anything, our viewers took this social message. I think at times it is amazing when celebrities and renowned personalities such as yourself discuss these, because I think you are in the authority and the position to impact that.
I feel sad to see. Recently, in a synagogue, somebody killed.
Yes, it just happened last weekend. Yes.
But you
very sad, Pittsburgh.
This gun culture is also very, very, very dangerous.
Scary, yes.
We have to control, they must have some kind of license, permission. Anybody can have a gun is a very dangerous thing for any country.
That is so true. And Khan Sahab, you know, it's so interesting. I feel like you're reading my mind in my next questions, because you reflected upon the fact that, you know, your wife is a Hindu. You never asked her to convert. That never even came as a conversation. You know, she's from Assam, so there was definitely a mix of culture there.
Yes.
And then, you know, you have a son who's also married to a Hindu lady. There's a lot of mixed culture, mixed religion. Do you think that's why the connection to music remains so strong? Because it is quite universal. And would you say spirituality is very connected in that too?
You see, Hindi mein is a very beautiful saying that Swar hi Ishwar hai.
Swar hi Ishwar hai, ji.
The sound connects you to God.
To God, yes.
My wife is an artist herself. She's a Bharatanatyam dancer. Disciple of great legendary Rukmani Arundale.
Ji.
I had the honor of meeting her, then Bala Saraswati, another great Bharatanatyam dancer. So after seeing her dance, you know, then I tried to propose her, and I felt as if God has sent her for me. And then she has given two musicians to the world, Aman and Ayan. They both are very, they are noble soul, very kind, compassionate human being, both of them. And they are very committed. They are the seventh generation continuing this. And they are receiving love and respect, love and blessings from India, all over the world. And they are, so we are all performing on the 3rd of November in New York for this symphony space. So New York is amazing, you know. New York has a beautiful audience.
Yes.
And I think every state in America, I had the honor of performing and visiting. And I received honorary citizenship also from many states in America.
That is amazing.
In fact, in 1984, state of Massachusetts declared 20th April as Amjad Ali Khan Day.
Wow. So we must do a coverage this time, Massachusetts. We will come for you April 20th.
20th April, yes. So that governor was, I'm forgetting his name, but he was very kind. So it's an honor for our country.
Beautiful.
We represent the culture and the tradition of India.
One last question that I've been saving this. You have worked basically your entire life in music, you know, generations in musical family. And now you have your sons working with you, who are a huge part of your life. What is one advice on life you would give to them, and a message that you would like to give to your children?
You see, for every young person, whether artist or whoever he is, if you want to achieve something in your life, you have to be patient and tolerant. Because the whole world, it's not about the young or age. The human beings, we have become intolerant and impatient. So, to achieve your goal of life, to achieve your manzil, you have to be tolerant, patient, and we Indian classical musicians, we are not in any rat race or horse race or any race. It's almost like an elephant walk. You have to walk with dignity and grace and be sincere, truthful to your presentation. And I respect my audience, I love my audience. And patience and tolerance and adjustment of life.
Yes.
It's the greatest prayer itself.
Yes.
No need to go to any religious building. If you can adjust within the family or in the office or two people, five people. But unfortunately, today's human being has become a most ferocious animal.
That's true.
Unfortunately. Because for any moment I see people shouting, screaming, and then gun, and then shooting and killing. And this racial problem has not ended.
That's true.
So what is the contribution of this education in the world? How to get rid of this? Because then arrogance.
Yes, that's true.
Arrogance is a disease. Cancer can be cured, but I hope medical world should produce a tablet of how to reduce and control this arrogance in human being, in every field.
That's true.
So one has to be very tolerant and one should have control to adjust in life.
Beautiful. I know I asked you, it was going to be my last question and it will be, but I have one important book in my hand, everyone. This is Khan Saab's recently released Masters and Masters book. He wrote it and there's a lot.
Published by Penguin.
And it is published by Penguin.
Random House.
Yes. And also, this book is actually his dedication to some of the greatest musicians. And who have just passed away. So I would love for you to just, you know, give us a little insight into what this book has meant for you, Khan Saab.
You know, these are 12 musicians, and only one I have included from South India, M.S. Subbulakshmi,
yes.
Legendary.
Yes.
In fact, my wife's name is after her, M.S. Subbulakshmi.
Oh, wow.
So, Pandit Ravi Shankar, Bismillah Khan Saab, Vilayat Khan Saab, Pandit Bhimsen Joshi, Pandit Kumar Gandhar, they are the 12 musicians. Because of them, the classical music became popular.
Yes.
In India, outside India. And there could have been more musicians. But these 12, I had personal equation. They came to my house, I went to their house, and I received a lot of love from all of them. So there are interesting anecdotes and there are interesting photographs also, which you can show to the viewers. So, in my growing up age, when I was 12 years old, they were quite established musicians. So, in every festival, they were must. One day I'm playing, next day Ravi Shankar ji is playing, third day Vilayat Khan Saab is playing.
Wow.
Sometime in the same evening, so suddenly there is a vacuum. They have gone away.
Yes.
So I miss them, and now I'm very happy, I'm very proud of so many young musicians in our country. In every field, sarod, sitar, tabla, gana, they are brilliant musicians.
Yes.
But I miss them, and that is the reason of this book.
Wow. Well, thank you so
much
for sharing.
It's a tribute to them.
Thank you so much for sharing this. I hope the viewers go out and get a copy of the book. I have my own personal one. Khan Saab, thank you so much for being
thank
with
you.
Us
thank
on
you.
ITV Gold. Any last minute messages out to all our ITV viewers?
No, I'm very happy to talk to you. You are so kind and graceful. God bless you. I hope you achieve your goal of life.
Oh, thank you so much. Well, I don't think I have words left to say. This was an amazing interview for myself, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. Stay tuned on to Inside Scoop on ITV Gold for so much more. I'm Aditi Lamba signing off. Thank you for joining us.